Gift of tongues is one of the two. What is the other two? He told me he thought you. Bianca, he did not teach you. You were not there. Sampad. Sorry? Did he use a scripture to prove that? Did he use a scripture to give you evidence that the angels are supposed to work for you? Somebody said that, right? Did Alfred teach you that? Did he teach you Psalms 103? Hello? Listen, my friend, if you forget this beautiful treasure, you will never be able to enjoy it. If somebody owes some money to you, you will write it down, you will remember, and you will keep remembering till you get what is yours, right? But here I am talking something more precious, much, much more precious than the money. Psalms 103 says, can somebody say it to me? Psalms 103 verse 20. Sampad?
Blessed.
Is the shadow of what is in heaven. Just as there is a bank on earth, there is a spiritual bank in heaven. Just as you deposit the money in your bank account, in the same way, when a person is speaking God's spoken word, it is deposited in your account in the spiritual bank. And now comes the time, listen, now comes the time that you are driving. And all of a sudden, there is an accident. When that impact takes place, you did not even get time to open your mouth and speak the word of faith. It was so instant. Or might be you were sleeping when that accident took place. But praise be to God, thank God for that deposit in the account. The angels will not wait for you to open your mouth and speak God's spoken word. They will go and withdraw the deposit which is in your account and get into action and stop that work of the devil that is coming to kill you. In this account, it is you who is supposed to open your mouth and speak God's spoken word. You can't go and tell the preacher, come on preacher, pray for me and pray on me that my bank account in heaven will get some deposit. It doesn't work that way. Imagine so many of us sitting here and they have not yet opened their account. So many of us sitting here, the angels are supposed to work for us and we never opened our mouth and spoke God's spoken word, and those angels are waiting to serve you, and now that you have not spoken God's spoken word for years and years, those angels have even forgot how to fly. They have not even flapped their wings for you because you failed to speak God's spoken word. And many of those angels might be having spider, what do you call that? Cobweb. There is dust on their wings. Ask your neighbor, is he talking about your angels? 1 Corinthians 13:1. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of... So there are different tongues. There are tongues of speaking of men. Means what? You are speaking a sentence, but it is a language somewhere in this world. I heard a testimony of a man, and he said, he always would speak in tongues, and he said, Lord, I do not understand. Is what I'm speaking, is it a language somewhere in the world? Can you please make me understand? And that morning he went to church and he was sitting there and the pastor was preaching. He was preaching about repentance. He was preaching about confessing your sin. He was preaching about living a life free from sin. And there was a foreigner who came that day to church, and he was sitting in one place. And this man opened his mouth and began to speak in tongues. And the foreigner was just sitting behind him. This man opened his mouth and spoke loudly in tongues. The man who was sitting behind, after some time, shook him and said, "Shh, shut up." The man did not understand. He said, "Why are you annoyed with me?" The foreigner said, "Are you going to make the whole church know what sin I'm committing?" This man was speaking in tongues, was confessing every sin of this man word. It's a language of the angels. But praise God, whether it's a language of this world or whether it's a language of the angels, whenever you speak, you activate the spiritual realm and a deposit is made in your account. There was this young lady, a young girl, and from a young age, she was touched by the Lord. And she began to go on missions to villages and preach the word. And she said, "Lord, I'm going to live for you. I made this decision, Lord, I will live for you and for you alone." So she never even thought of getting married. As she was doing her missionary work, she met a young youth who was on fire for God. And day and night he would go and preach. They both became friends. And they began to go on missions. Then suddenly they found that they were getting more and more closer to each other. And they decided to get married. They got married and the missions were going on. After marriage, she got a baby. With the baby, she began to go on a mission with her husband. The next year, she got another baby. And the babies kept on coming. And now she had four babies. And because of these babies, she could not go on a mission. The husband would leave her behind and go distant places preaching the gospel and then come back home. After a few days, after a few weeks, years went by. This girl, this lady began to cry. And she said, "God, you know my first love is you. I told you, Lord, I don't want to get married. Now I'm not only married, I've got these children, and the very fire that I have is getting quenched. I can see my husband go. I want to go with him. Please do something." And she would sit and cry. But she would never talk to her husband about this incident. She was very sad. It went on for weeks. It went on for months. One day, the Lord gave her a vision. And in that vision, she saw herself with the Lord. The Lord taking her hand and saying, "Come with me, I want to show you something." And he took her to a big room, big huge room. And he said, "Well, look around. And when you're finished, I'll be waiting for you at this door." So this young girl left Jesus' hand and began to go around the room. And she began to look around. And everywhere in that room was only one thing. Pictures of different people, photographs of people. And she began to go around and she began to look around and she found some of them she knew. But more than 90% of the people she never knew. There were people who were black, there were people who were white, there were people from different places around the world. After all that she saw, she came to Jesus and she said, "I do not understand Jesus. Only a few people I know, but I don't know the others." And Jesus said to her, "I want to tell you something. Every day when your husband is going on a mission, you are praying in the Spirit. And when you are praying in the Spirit of God has been praying on your behalf and praying for all these people whose photographs you are seeing. They all got saved because you are praying in the Spirit and you did not even know these were the lost souls, but when you prayed in the Spirit, by your prayer, the spiritual realm got activated and their souls got saved." My friend, there are many times said, you don't even know whom you are praying for. But always remember, when a person is praying a scripture or is praying in the spirit, the words coming out of your mouth activates the spiritual realm. Might be your preacher is in a village and the people are planned to kill him, and you are praying in tongues. The Spirit of God, the Word of God says, the Spirit of God intercedes according to the will, the purpose and plan of God. God wants to save that person, but he is looking out for somebody who can open his mouth and speak. Have you ever seen Jesus heal anybody without opening his mouth? Have you ever seen in the Bible God created the world without opening his mouth? Everything in creation gets created and gets activated by words. Your words are the powerful tool in the spiritual realm. And that is why God is saying, when you open your mouth and start speaking in the spirit, the words that are coming out are faith-filled, powerful words that activates the spiritual realm, and everything is turned around into victory. Clapping again and again and again, and the people in this world will say, Mama, you are only 40, after another 15 years you can retire. What's your age, 40? 45, okay. The world will say, after 55 you are retired. In God's kingdom there is no retirement. Even your last breath that you are breathing, you are praying in the spirit, that last breath and that last word coming out of your mouth is still destroying the work of the devil. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I just read it now because my time's up. Okay? We'll just go through some. When you're praying in tongues, you will have supernatural understanding of the kingdom of God. When I first read the Bible, I did not understand anything. But the more and more I began to speak in tongues, the Lord began to enlighten and give me more and more understanding. Praise God. Look at that 1 Corinthians 14:13. Therefore, let him that speaks in an unknown tongue pray that he may interpret. What's the meaning of the word interpret? Interpret means to understand. A person can come and speak. Now, my brother, Arlite, I speak in English and he is speaking in Konkani because he understands English. What is he doing? He is not interpreting, he is translating. So what's the meaning of the word translation? He is speaking word to word, but in a different language. Now what is interpretation? Interpretation is when a person has spoken for 10 minutes and the other person understands what has been spoken and he comes and gives the meaning in 2 or 3 lines. He gives you the summary. So interpretation means to understand and speak in a summary. Now for example, when I come here, I have to preach. But I don't know what to preach. I don't know what testimonies to take. So now I am totally depending on God, asking Him, Lord, what do you want me to speak to your people? So when I am speaking, I keep saying, Lord, I thank you that you have given me the gift of interpretation. Now somebody will say, how did you receive the gift of interpretation? The same way that this brother was sitting here, he received the gift of tongues. Yesterday we learned Mark 11:24, whatsoever you ask in prayer, first believe that you have received it and then you shall have it. So I gave him a pen and I said, have you received it? He said, yes. Then I gave him an invisible pen and I said, have you received it? He said, yes. I said, can you see it? No. Can you touch it? No. Can you feel it? know, then how do you know? He said, because the scripture says, I believe it and then I shall have it. In the same way, the word of God says, anyone who has the gift of tongue must pray to God for the gift of interpretation. Now, according to Mark 11, 24, have you received it? Come on. And when you believe you have received it, you shall have it. So when I am standing here, I don't know what testimony to give, what examples to give, how to make you understand. But praise God, when I'm standing here, He is helping me to interpret what I spoke in tongues, in human wisdom, and now those thoughts are coming to me, and now I'm speaking according to the interpretation that I'm receiving by the power of the Holy Spirit. If I'm not connected with the Holy Spirit, I will not be able to talk from morning till night. But as long as I'm connected, I can go on and go on and go on and go on and not get tired. Because there is a river that is flowing. And that's why the word of God says, when a person is speaking in tongues, he will begin to get understanding beyond his natural understanding. This is powerful. Build up yourself on your most holy faith. I should add one more scripture there. The book of Jude has got only one chapter. I do not know what is the verse. It's, I think, 20, 21 or 22. The Bible says, when a person is praying in the Spirit, when a person is praying in the Spirit, he will build up his faith. It is faith that gives you the victory, right? Hello? It is faith that gives you the victory, right? Faith makes you an overcomer. And the Bible teaches us in the book of Jude that when a person is praying in tongues, can you just give me the scripture, some of you from the team? A person who is praying in tongues, it is somewhere around 20th verse. 20. But you, beloved, building up yourself on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. He is saying, when you are praying in the Holy Ghost, my beloved, you are building up yourself on your most holy faith. If somebody is saying, hey brother, I don't have much faith. Hey, you just got a tool to grow faith. We must all grow faith. How do you grow faith? By speaking in tongues. And look at the next verse. Keeping yourself in the love of God. Looking for the mercy of our God, Jesus Christ, unto eternal life. There are two things that will grow in you. The first thing will be the faith of God. And that faith of God will help you to experience the love of God. And now when you experience the love of God and the mercy of God, you will go around giving love and mercy. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Didn't you like this one, Mama? Ah, you are busy, right? Look at what a powerful benefit. I speak in tongues, my faith begins to grow. I speak in tongues, I experience the love of God. I speak in tongues, I receive the mercy of God. Now all that I've received, I can go and pour it in somebody's life and change somebody's future. Praise God. Hallelujah. Speaking in tongues gets you filled with the Spirit. What is the meaning of the word being filled with the Holy Spirit? Okay. Supposing I come to your house to stay for 2 days, and you got a house where there are 3 to 4 rooms in the house. Don't worry. There are 3 to 4 rooms in your house. And you're saying, brother, I'm so happy that you came to my house. But please see to it that you stay in the living room and you can use the washroom. But please don't go in other rooms. Now, that means I am dwelling in this house, I am staying in this house, but I do not have the freedom to go to every place. Right? But after one day you say, brother, you can go to any place. When you give me a permission to go to every place, in the same way, the Holy Spirit is in you, and if you are saying, Holy Spirit, you can visit this room and this room. This room or this area of your life, of my life, I do not give you permission to go into this room. Let me give you an example. The Bible says Stephen was filled with the Holy Spirit. When does the Bible say Stephen was filled with the Holy Spirit? The Bible says Stephen was filled with the Holy Spirit when the people were casting stones and killing him. Supposing people come and pick up stones and they're casting out stones to kill you, where do you think your focus will be? On the stones, on the people, or on God? Let's be honest. Give me an honest answer. Stones. But when this thing is going on, where do you think Stephen's focus was on? He said, I can see Jesus standing at the right hand of the Father. When your focus is all the time fixed, look here, please don't get distracted. When your focus is fixed on God, what a perfect timing. She just starts walking and everybody wants to see you. What is she doing? If a lady walks on the top and you are out of focus, what about people coming and throwing stones at each other? The Holy Spirit is so good. Thank you, Holy Spirit. He's so good. He said, let me show the people what's being filled with the Holy Spirit. The lady comes up and she wants to have a fellowship with God and she is in her own world, but everybody wants to see. Yet I'm speaking to you the word of God and your focus is gone. You're out of focus. A person who is filled with the Holy Spirit is a person that no matter what circumstances, no matter what situation is going around in his life, he is still focused on God. When a person is speaking in tongues, his spirit is so connected with God that he's been filled with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has got full permission